Hi there. I haven't made a video in quite a while, so I decided to show you how to seam a little baby bootie. This is how it will look when it's finished. Absolutely adorable. And it has a little matching hat with a bow as well, for a baby of course. But this is how it looks after you finish doing all the knitting. And there's still quite a bit of work to do, so I'm going to show you how to do all of that. First, I'll tell you how to get the pattern. It's in a book from Bernat. Let's see here if I can find the front of the page so I can show you the cover. There it is. It's called Bernat Adorables. That's a pattern book you can get from the Yarnspirations website. www.yarnspirations.com. Now let me see if I can find that pattern again so you can see how the photo looks. There. There's the photo that shows you how it's going to look. And there's my finished hat and baby bootie. So it turned out exactly like the pattern said it would. I'm a happy girl about that. So if you want to buy the pattern, just go to yarnspirations.com and you'll be able to purchase the book, and it'll have this pattern in there. And this pattern is called the Bow Accent Set. That's what it's called. Pattern number 7 in that book. Now, let me show you how to seam this baby bootie. Now here is how it looks when you finish doing all the knitting. And I can't tell you how to do all the knitting because you have to buy the pattern. But, you know, it has some shaping here for the foot. And you can see here how it looks the same as that. So what I have to do now is the part that a lot of people hate to do, which I don't mind doing. To me, seaming is just another part of knitting. And I want to take my time and get it done right instead of just flopping it together, because if you just throw it together, it's going to look messy. And you know how careful you were with all of your knitting stitches, so you should be just as careful with your seaming. So let me tell you what I'm doing before I just start doing it. So here's the way it looks on the outside. Now when you're knitting a project, sometimes you'll see RS written on your pattern, and what that means is right side. And that's the pretty side. It's the side that everybody's going to see when they look at your finished product. So when you see RS on your pattern, it's referring to this side. WS is wrong side, and that's this side on the inside of your bootie, or of your sweater, or whatever it is you're making. So the wrong side is the side that nobody's going to see. It's just going to be on the inside of your project. So now that you understand right side and wrong side, I'm on the right side right now, but I have some ends way down deep inside there that I need to weave in before I do this seaming. So I'm going to turn it inside out. Now I'm on the wrong side. And I want to weave in these little ends that I have here. So I'm going to thread my yarn needle. And I'm going to weave it in along that little ridge there, because it'll kind of blend in there well. And plus it won't bother the baby's foot. Because I know it bugs me when there's a ridge or something in my shoe. I don't think a baby would like it either. So put it along a spot that's easy to see. There. And I went back the other way to secure it. Now I can cut that thread and toss it away. Now I have one more end here on the inside I need to weave in. I think I heard a truck pull up at my house. I'm supposed to have somebody come work on my internet. And you know how they say, I'll be there between 8 and 12. Ah. So you never know what time they're going to get there. So I'll weave in that end. Now I'm going to pass the last stitch I wove in and go back through there. There. Now that end is woven in, and I'm ready to start seaming. So now I'm going to turn it right side out again. So now I've got the right side showing, and I'm just going to line it up, and you just fold it straight in half like that. And it will lay out like it's supposed to after you finish. Don't worry, it's not going to have a weird thing on the bottom. That part is going to fold in after you seam it, and it'll lie just right, make the bottom of the bootie. See? It'll work out. So I'm going to start at the very top up here where this ribbing is. I'm going to move all this other stuff out of the way. Hopefully it'll help you see what I'm doing a little bit better, because here's where the detail work starts. So I only have a little bit. I'm just going to go as far as I can with this, and it's just one way that I can seam and get rid of this end at the same time. I could start with a new strand of yarn, but I prefer to just use the yarn that's already attached. So this is already attached right here at this corner, so I'm just going to go straight across to the other corner and hook it on right there. Now my corners are attached. Now some people like to pin their project that they're going to be seaming, but for something this small it's not really necessary. I can hold it together and see where I'm going. And I'm just going to do a whip stitch seam. And a whip stitch is when you just get a strand here and a strand there. So I've got a strand from either side. I'm not going to get two strands from each side, just one. One strand here and one strand there. And I just pull it straight through. And I'm going to go to the very next little spot there where I have one strand here and one strand there. Pull it straight across. And just so you know, I'm using Bernat Baby Coordinates yarn in the color Sweet Pink. And it is sweet. One here, one there. So make sure you're just under one strand and it'll make a nice neat little seam. One strand here, one strand there. Pull it. The other reason I like to use the ends instead of another strand of yarn is because if I had woven in these ends, I might be trying to seam into those ends and it would not be secure. There. So don't pull it too tight. You don't want to pucker it up, because if you pull it real tight, then it makes this back part not sit pretty. So now that that's secured, I can just leave that hanging there because I ran out of yarn. So now I'm going to use one of these ends and I'm going to go up the other way. And I noticed that when I did this before, I tied this in a knot. So I'm going to untie the knot now. Whenever you're knitting and you have to start using a different yarn, it's good to secure it with a knot so that you can untie it later. Alright, now I'm just going to pull that snug. Let's see which one of these is longer. This one's longer, so I'm going to use this. Yeah, that'll be fine. So that'll be enough there. So now I just fold it again, line it up nice and neat where the ends match. I'm going to do another whip stitch. So I'm just going to come straight across, get one strand here. And you'll just continue doing this until all of your seam has been done. So it's an easy, simple, quick little seam. One strand here, one strand there. Pull it through. And then after you finish doing this little seam, you just put all your ends, the ends that are hanging like this, move them to the inside of the fabric, the wrong side, and weave them in. That's all there will be left to do. So it's easy to do. Look at have one more little spot there. You see where my finger's poking through? I have one more spot I need to secure with a stitch. So I'll get one strand here, one strand there. Pull it through. There. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie these two together, not in a knot, just a little tie like that. And that secures that. And then I can move those to the inside and weave them in. So let me show you how I do that. La, 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 la. I'll just do this little one here. Ooh, I can't do it, it's too short. I'm going to put my needle through to the inside, and then I'm going to thread it through that hole. There. Now I'm going to pull my needle inside, and that pulls that in. And now I'll turn it inside out. There's my end. I'm going to weave it in. So I'll just go through a few stitches here. There. Just like that. My hands are kind of shaky today. I drank too much coffee. I do have a little bit of a tremor too, so that's why my hands shake. There's that. Now I want to go back the other way to secure that end, because it's not quite secure yet. Just a car. I wonder when my internet service guy is going to get here. Maybe it'll be an internet service girl. We'll have to wait and see. Pull that through. End is secured. So that's what I'll do with every one of these little strands here. So now I'm ready to go down toward the base of the foot. Fold that over, thread my needle, do another little whip stitch. One strand. See, this is easy. This is not hard. I don't understand why people are afraid to seam. There's nothing to it. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Alright, now I'm going to tie this in a little simple tie. Just to secure it a little bit. There. Now I'm going to use this longer end to do the bottom of the foot. Little whip stitch. So I get one strand here and one strand there. Pull that. One strand there. Hear my clock. I'm sitting in my craft room. I have a clock over there on the other side. It has a loud tick. Sometimes I sit here at night knitting and it almost puts me to sleep. It reminds me of the old grandfather clock that my papa used to have in his house. He'd sit there in his recliner. I'd sit beside him watching Captain Kangaroo, I think. And he'd sit there and he'd start to nod off listening to that clock. It used to be funny to me. I'd watch him because he's just sitting up in his chair and his head would start rolling back. His mouth would come open and then his head would fall back and it would wake him up. I always thought that was funny. I used to like to watch him fall asleep. Alright, so move that to the middle and pull it through. Uh-oh, I think that came off my needle. Ah, there. Yay. So now all I have left to do is attach my little bow, which I made earlier. And you'll find the instructions on how to make those bows in that pattern book, Burnett Adorables. But before I attach my bow, I have to weave in all my ends. Man, I still don't see my internet service guy. I just keep seeing cars go by. My internet keeps coming off and going on and coming back off, and it's weird. Goes off, goes on. So I think I need a new, what's that box called? Modem? New modem box? Whatever that box is. I need a new one because it's not working good. Alright, weave in this end. So I'm on the inside here, remember? We're not weaving these ends on the outside. That wouldn't look good. I'm on the wrong side here, which is correct. I like my little trimmers. I have arthritis, and these pop back open after you cut with them, so they're Fiskars Soft Touch. I like them. And they're very sharp. Believe me, I know. I cut my finger on there once. I was like, ah! What a drag. Hate it when stuff like that happens. You don't realize how much you use a finger until you hurt it. Then you realize, man, I use this thing all day long. So you pull that through. One time, I hurt this finger here. I can still see a little tiny spot there. I cut like the whole tip of it off right there. It was just skin, but still, man, it hurt. And I asked the doctor, I said, why does it hurt so bad? He said, there's a whole bunch of nerve endings in your fingertips. They're very sensitive, so that's why it hurts so bad when you cut the tip of your finger. It was not fun. And he put this huge bandage on it. And I had to play organ at church the next day. And I had that huge band-aid on that finger. It was hilarious. So I was playing like this. Kept that one finger up, and I was playing with all the rest of my fingers, and it was a real big bandage. Oh. So the choir said, Sandy, stay away from scissors on Saturday night, please. Because they wanted me to be ready to play the organ on Sunday morning. But I was able to play even with a hurt finger. Okay, weave in this last little end. Ah, la, 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 la. Put that there. There. Ba-da. There. Trim that off. There. I'm going to turn it back right side out and see where that seam was when we folded it and we went all the way around through there. When you pop it out, just make that little sole of the bootie like that. And there you go, there's your bootie. And I usually push out the top part so that it stands right, just like that. Ta-da! There's our bootie. And now all I have left to do is attach my little bow, which will go right on top. And then it'll look just like the other one. Easy peasy. Aren't those going to be sweet? With their little hat and booties. Precious! I can't wait to give those to my customer. I hope she's happy with them. So there you go. That's how to seam a bootie. I hope you have fun with your yarn projects, and I'll see you soon on the Yarnspirations website. Now, if you want to talk to me on the forum, you're more than welcome to. Just go to www.yarnspirations.com and then look way up at the top of the screen and you'll see community. So click that little thing that says community and it'll take you to the forum. So you'll see on that page, you'll see Vicki Howell off to the left. Then you'll see a little blog thing that you can click. And then there's a thing you can click for the forum. So click that forum and go in there and join and talk to me about the things you're making, because I'd like to see what you do. Talk to you later. Bye.